Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is very different from any video that I've ever put out on my channel, but I think you guys are going to really enjoy this. So if you follow me on Instagram, you'll probably remember that I put up a little question box that you guys could ask a photographer questions. And here we go, here we have him. This is Corey, say hi.
Great intro, hello everyone.
You know how it is, it's very raw. We just finished doing a shoot and we also filmed a video for Corey's YouTube channel.
Woo!
So you should definitely go check it out, especially if you're interested in photography, retouching, cameras, all the fun stuff. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna get Corey to answer some of you guys' most asked questions. Four models from a photographer's perspective. Here we go. Okay, so tell us a little bit about who you are, what you do.
Well, my name's Corey Vandeplu at Corey Photo on Twitter and Instagram. The majority of my work is photography, but I also do a lot of film work, a lot of video editing, documentary filmmaker. Once you're in the kind of visual realm, you can kind of use your talents and spread them over a lot of different projects. And that's how I'm about. It's more about multimedia and whatever the media is, that's how I use it.
That's amazing. And you're also a Canadian, so
also
we
Canadian,
love that.
Yes.
Okay, so the first question is, how do I make a photographer's life easier / how do I always be prepared?
Interesting.
As a model.
As a model. How do you always be prepared? The thing is to go in with a plan. If you know, the photographer should know what he's shooting, and you should know that as well. You should be very clear about what the purpose of the shoot is and what images you're going to be getting out of the shoot. And once you have that conversation, which almost nobody has, with the photographer, they kind of just let the photographer do something. I always say it's a collaboration, it's not just me shooting you. So if you have that conversation beforehand, that's gonna make you miles ahead of everyone else. What to bring, how to be prepared, what the shoot's for. I mean, you're already gonna be in that headspace.
Do you have some tips for set etiquette? Like, how do you feel about models asking to see the photos, that kind of thing?
Yes, set etiquette. I mean, it's really contextual. So that's like asking, how do you be social when you go out? You can't just, there's no set rules. You kind of have to feel it. The biggest thing is having confidence. When somebody asks, can I see a photo? I generally have no problem. And if I don't, I'll say respectfully, these aren't ready to be seen. And you should be okay with that. You should be able to read the room as a model. You should already have this kind of skill in your back pocket, how to talk to people, how to show proper respect, all that kind of stuff. Yeah, set etiquette's tough because shooting with just a regular photographer, like kind of what we just did, versus going on to like a high-end commercial set, like that's gonna be different. I can't tell you how to act on this set and then you go do the same thing on that set. So it is really just being contextual. Reading the room, being polite, being Canadian helps with that polite thing. Being polite, being respectful, and asking questions. Curiosity is generally rewarded.
Someone asks, how can I shoot with you or someone as good as you when I'm not an established model?
It's tough. I generally don't use Instagram. Instagram's not the best for that kind of things. There's a lot of sleaze out there. There's a lot of amateurs. There's just, you don't really know where your work's going to be and the consistency isn't there. Emails are always the proper channel. You go to the website, you find out what their email is, you do the proper research and you ask that way. Generally, if it's a really high-end photographer, you have someone answering your emails, so they will do the filtering. If it's just a normal person, at least you're asking through their email and through that proper channel. I don't think you should do it through socials.
What is the most important for the photographer?
What's most important? I think the most important thing is connecting with the subject. I don't think your tools matter. The lighting is not as important as connection. You can have the best lighting and the best camera, but if you don't truly connect with your subject, and what's the point? And if you're not connecting with the subject and you've set up your camera and your lighting, then it's just a technical exercise. It's not really observing and capturing the moment, being a mirror and reflecting what you're seeing.
Do you have any tips for creating movement in the shot?
One of the things I always say right when someone sits down is, when I ask you to do something, just do it in slow motion. That way you can kind of, as you're moving, you can kind of capture that motion. And then there's also, I do a lot of things with, if you look at my work, there's a lot of slow shutter and a lot of blurring effects. So I like that. It's all about experimenting. Have the model move, see what works, what doesn't work. What works for me might not work for you and vice versa. So again, the constant theme in this interview is gonna be practice more and shoot more often.
People often say my eyes look dead in pictures, not mine, but this is the person asking. How do I make my eyes look more alive?
The light. Generally, if you're even looking at me right now, I might not have these specular highlights, but if we shifted this way and the light was hitting me straight on, which you'll see in those moving portraits, it's those specular highlights, letting a light go into your eyes and illuminating them is really what brings the life. If you look at one of my favorite photographers who I assisted, Platon, every single one of his photos has a big blasted front-on light, and that just makes you kind of say, holy shit, every time you look at their eyes. So it's lighting, and I think it's more lighting than actually what you're doing. If you have dead eyes in every shot, that's weird.
That's interesting, because I would have thought that it would have been something to do with us.
Yeah, but if you're, like, are you squinting? Dead eyes usually means a lack of connection, even. So I feel like if you and I are connecting and we're getting this, like, you're into it. But if you're not into what we're doing, for example, if you've been set up on a shitty shoot and you're not into what is happening, you're gonna see that in the eyes. Windows to the soul, they say. But yeah, it's usually lighting and a lack of connection.
The last question that I want to ask you is, what is your favorite thing that beginner models have done where you say, okay, this is something that I feel like all models should do, or even experienced models, that makes your job easier?
Mainly shooting models. I'm sure you've worked with photographers before that are new and they just kind of stand there and you're kind of looking for direction. I always think like a photo shoot is like a car and each person is a wheel on a car. So if the photographer, the makeup artist, and the stylist are great, then the model can kind of be lackluster and that car's still gonna move. So I think a tip is, if you on set, you should know what works for you and your angles right off the bat. So at least you can kind of get into a rhythm and get shooting, and you are driving that vehicle. If you just sat down and we were shooting and I just kind of started going click, click, that'll usually create a lot of weird awkwardness and you don't know what to do and he doesn't know what to do. So being able to have that confidence and drive that shoot, especially get into, you do it right away. Right when you sit down, you know exactly what to do. I almost have to tell you, bring it back.
Bring it back.
Yeah. When I shoot with my wife, we'd barely speak. There's almost no words being said, but that comes from consistency, shooting a lot, working together. Just comes with time.
Thank you so much. This was even helpful for me. So I'm sure it's going to be helpful for a lot of people. I really appreciate your time.
Great. Thank you.
And yeah, I can't wait to see what we created today.
Beautiful. It's going to be good.
Thank you guys. Make sure to check out Corey's channel in the description below. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.
Beautiful.